Good morning, students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine at home. Be safe and stay at home. Today, we are going to learn the subject social studies. In social studies, today we are going to learn lesson 9. Lesson 9. From the picture, can you guess the name of the lesson? Yes, your guess is right. It's a grassland. The name of the lesson today we are going to learn is the treeless grasslands. The treeless grasslands. Before moving on into the lesson, we are going to do one exercise. Shall we do it now? Circle the correct answer in each. You all know about wheat, no? In this lesson, we are going to read about the wheat producing region. So, how much do you know about the wheat? Here, we are going to circle the correct answer. Number one, wheat is a food or cash crop. Wheat is a food or cash crop? It's a food. And then number two, Tamil Nadu or Punjab is the largest wheat producing state in India. Which is the largest wheat producing state? Yes, your guess is right. It's Punjab. And number three, wheat grows best in cool and moist or hot and wet climate. Where does it grow? It grows in cool and moist climate. And number four, North or South India is largely a wheat consuming region. Yes, you know the answer. North Indian peoples use wheat. And then, shall we do the answers now? Wheat is a food crop. Tamil Nadu or Punjab is the largest wheat producing state in India? Punjab. Wheat grows best in cool and moist climate. North or South Indian is largely a wheat consuming region? North. Yes, now we completed. Shall we pass on to the lesson? Grasslands. Grasslands are large plains of grass. Grasslands are large plains of grass. They are found in warm and dry places. Grasslands are found in warm and dry places. In these areas, in which areas? Grassland areas, the rainfall is too little for forest to grow. The rainfall is too little in this grassland, but just enough to prevent the land from turning into a desert. What is happening there? Hence, there are very few trees and bushes in grassland. What can we see in the grassland? We can see very few trees and bushes. The rainfall is too little in this area. Now, look at it. Most of the grasslands, the yellow one or the grasslands, the yellow one or the grasslands, most of the grasslands are in the temperate zone. The grasslands are in the temperate zone. They are known by different names in different continents. They are known by different names and different in different continents. Very good. You all know about continents, no? Yes. Today we are going to learn about the prairie. The prairie. I show you the map, no? In that continent, in some yellow color, I show you, no? Those lands are grasslands. In these grasslands, today we are going to learn about prairie. What do you mean by prairie? Prairie is a French word. It's a French word which means grassland. Which means grasslands. What's a prairie? What do you mean by prairie? Prairie is a grassland. Very good. The prairies are a vast stretch of gently sloping temperate grasslands in North America. Where it is situated? Where the prairie is situated? It is in North America. Where it is situated? It's in North America. Okay. Now we are going to learn about the location of the prairie. The prairies extend from Canada in the north to Mexico in the south. The prairies extend from Canada to in the north to Mexico in the south. Mexico in the south. It covers the whole of central USA. It covers the whole of central USA. The prairies extend from Canada in the north to Mexico in the south. It covers the whole of central USA. Look at here, students. This is a prairie in, it's situated in North America. Now look at here. Now we are going to learn about the land. The prairies were once covered with thick tall grasses. Thick tall grasses. Today these flat and fertile lands are the biggest farming regions of the world. The prairies were once covered with thick and tall grasses. Today these flat and fertile lands are the biggest farming regions of the world. These are the two rivers, the Mississippi River and the Missouri River are the two big rivers that flow through this region. That flow through, this is the Mississippi River and this is the Missouri River. These two rivers that flow in through this region. And then some more facts about Mississippi River. This is the longest river in North America. Mississippi River is the longest river in North America. Which is the longest river in North America? Mississippi River. It rises in Lake Itasca and drains into the Gulf of Mexico. And in the author Mark Twain, The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn, describes the people and the places along this river. Okay. Then we are going to learn about the climate in this region. In the prairies, winters are cold and summers are hot. In prairies, how is the climate? In prairies, the climate, winters are cold and summers are hot. And the rainfall is moderate. Moderate means average. Rainfall is average, about 52 to 70 centimeter, and occurs mostly in the summer season. When rainfall occurs in prairies, it occurs mostly in the summer season. What's the average rainfall there? 52 to 70 centimeter. Shall we pass on to the next one? Next, we are going to learn about the vegetation. A wide variety of plants grow in these grasslands. A wide variety of plants grow in these grasslands. Trees are rare in the prairies. Which is very rare in prairies? Trees are very rare. Except along the rivers. Except along the rivers, the trees are very rare. Near the river, we can see. Except along the river, we can see ek trees are rare in prairies except along the rivers. Grass grows quickly during the spring season and changes to hay in autumn. Grass grows quickly during the spring season. The grass grows very high. We learn it, no? Yes. Grass grows quickly during the spring season and changes to hay in autumn. Hay means a dry grass, straw. Otherwise, we can say it as straw. Okay. Next, we are going to learn about the wildlife. The animals that live here have adapted themselves to the semi-arid climate. The animals that live here have adapted themselves to this semi-arid climate. The animals live in this region is adapted to the climate. If it's very hot, it can adapt its body. They can withstand very hot summers and freezing cold winters. In any kind, in both the climates, these animals can live. Shall we see some animals that live in this region? This is a bison, lives in this region, and prairie dog. This is a prairie chicken and this is coyote. Prairie chicken and coyote. These are the animals we can see in this region. These animals can adapt themselves to live in the hot summers and freezing cold winters. You all understand the topic about the prairies. Prairie, how, where it is located, how is the land, what's the climate there, vegetation there, and wildlife there. You all understand these five topics clearly. I hope you all understand this nicely. Today's homework, you have to read the lesson 9, page number 59, 60 and 61 in the book. You have to read the lesson in the book. Then only you can get a clear picture of the lesson. Okay, students, we will meet in the next session. Thank you, children.